ready.
Oh, the weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. And since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Man, it doesn't show signs of stopping, and I brought me some corn for popping. The lights are turned way down low, let it snow, let it snow. When we finally kiss goodnight, how I'll hate going out in the storm. But if you really hold me tight, all the way home I'll be warm. And the fire is slowly dying, and my dear, we're still goodbye. But as long as you'd love me,
let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Oh, hi kids, happy Wednesday. Man, I was just thinking, well, actually, I was getting ready to go outside and open car doors for the preschool and the kindergarten. They're expecting me. The weather sure has changed. It's definitely cold outside. Some snow might be nice. Maybe, maybe, maybe. You just never know. All right, let's get this Wednesday started. Mrs. Elam, start us in prayer.
Good morning, Rockets. Our song for today is Strength for the Journey.
Thank you so much to Mrs. Elam for starting our day off in prayer. I know earlier in the week on Monday, when she did her prayer, she talked about this beautiful season of Advent, which is the weeks that we prepare for the coming of Jesus on Christmas. So one of the things that Mrs. Elam and I thought would be special is for us to have our own manger, and each day we're going to add people to the manger or animals, and then we're going to read a little bit about what those people meant to the birth of Jesus. So today we are going to add the three wise men. Remember, they brought gold and frankincense and myrrh. They didn't need to social distance then, kids, so we're going to put them right by each other. All right, there are our three wise men, and I'm going to read a little bit about the three wise men to you. Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of King Herod. Behold, magi from the east arrived in Jerusalem, saying, "Where is the newborn king of the Jews? We saw his star at its rising and have come to do him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was greatly troubled, and all of Jerusalem with him. Assembling all the chief priests and the scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They said to him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it has been written through the prophet." Then Herod called the Magi secretly and ascertained from them the time of the star's appearance. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search for the child. When you have found him, bring me word that I too may go to pay him homage." After their audience with the king, they set out. And behold, the star that they had seen at its rising preceded them until it came and stopped over the place where the child was. They were overjoyed at seeing the star. And on entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed for their country by another way. Okay, we're going to go ahead and add our stars. Yesterday was December 1st, and today is December 2nd. All right, kids, it's time for our national day, and I'm going to let this video speak for itself on National Mutt Day.
It might seem crazy what I'm about to say.
Challenge, not rapping like singing, rapping like wrapping presents. So let's see how they did. It's the Christmas Wrapping Challenge. Also on this email, you will find a vote sheet so you can vote for who you thought won between Mr. Elam and Mrs. Elam. Take it away.
Ho, 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 kids. We have a special treat for you today. Let me fix my mustache. Today, Mr. Elam and I are going to be doing a Christmas wrapping challenge. So, normally I am the much better gift wrapper of the two of us, but today we're going to put that to the test. So, we have little boxes here, we are going to wrap. Now, to make it a little more challenging, we are going to wrap them in oven mitts. So, we each get 60 seconds on the clock. Okay, so here we go. I'm gonna be first, and let's see which of us is the better rapper by the end of it. Rapper with a W, not the...
All right, you've got 60 seconds on the clock. On your mark, get set, go.
That's why he wears oven mitts. Oh dear. Fingers in there. Oh yeah, oh yeah. That's great. Oh, look at this.
Seconds.
No! No! Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Yeah. Oh no. Oh no! My tape!
You got 10 seconds
guys,
left.
No! Guys! I'm gonna win this! Oh, it's stuck to me! Oh, this is not good, kids.
Time's up.
Oh, look at that! Alright kids, now that is going to be a tough act to follow, but here we go. 60 seconds, on your mark, get set, go!
The secret's not to panic.
I wasn't panicking, I was in the zone!
Oh, I'm way ahead of you.
I ran out of tape. Oh, no. 20 seconds.
There we go.
You ripped it. 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, time's up. Okay, kids, which do you think was the best? Was it Mrs. Elam's? Or was it Mr. Elam's?
Actually, hold on.
We've come to the point in the show where we're ready to finish for the day. If you're not going to join me to sing and dance, this is where I say goodbye to you. I hope you have a fantastic Wednesday. Thanks for joining me this morning. Remember that I love you, and I can't wait to see you in a couple of weeks. I've got some very special friends who are going to sing and dance with me today. That's right, our pre-K's here. So we're going to go ahead and do a song. So if you want to stick around and sing and dance, let's go. You ready?
Ready.
All right.